Is there a limit to skateboarding? How far can skateboarding go? These are the questions that I've been thinking about for 2 days, and here's the answer that I came up with. The answer that I came up with is yes, there is a limit to skateboarding, and no, there is no limit to skateboarding. So let me start off with the there is no limit to skateboarding. Yes, there is no limit to the tricks that could be done on a skateboard. It doesn't matter what kind of form of skateboarding you do, whether it's street, park, freestyle, vert. Skateboarding is still evolving, and all the tricks being done on a skateboard are also evolving. Do you think the skaters 20 years ago knew that kids nowadays are going to be grinding 16-stair handrails? Of course not. They didn't even know what a handrail was at the time. Skateboarding has never stopped evolving, and it's still evolving to this day, seeing with the new clips that are coming out. Let me explain the evolution of skateboarding and how skateboarding evolves. Whether you're a pro or a beginner, obviously you have to start with the basics of skateboarding. Meaning you have to learn how to ollie first before you're able to kickflip. You work on your kickflip for about a year to perfect it, so that way you're able to kickflip better, you can perfect it, you have the right pop, you have the right flick, it feels good under your feet. And that is the first form of evolution. So you started with an ollie, and now you have a kickflip. That is a form of transformation evolution, meaning that you're transforming one trick into another, so that way you have a new trick, which is the kickflip. And it all started from the basics, which is an ollie. Whether you're a pro, whether you're a beginner, you always have to start off with the basics, so that way you could evolve your tricks into something else. Now let me talk to you guys about another form of evolution. So now that you have your kickflip, you're able to get the pop right, you get the height right, you got the feeling right. Now it's time for you to take it to a rail. And now that you want to take it to the rail, you want to learn kickflip front boards. Well, now you got to learn front boards. Once you get them front boards, let's say it takes another 2 months. Now that you have your kickflips and your front boards, now it's time for you to try the kickflip front board, and you try and try and try and try until you finally land it, and it only took you about maybe 6 months to land it. To perfection, of course, so you land it every single try, and you also make sure that the feeling is good, the pop is right. This is the second form of evolution, combining tricks into one. So in this example, I combined the kickflip and the front board together to make the kickflip front board, which is one full trick. And there is no limit to how far you could combine tricks. You could have kickflip front board, shove out, which is a brand new trick, just adding another step. And you could keep adding on tricks until you feel like you can't do anymore. There is one more form of evolution for skateboarding, which is taking your tricks to bigger stuff and taking impact much more higher. Now you could take your trick and take it down any obstacle you feel like. You could take it down stairs, you could take it down handrails, you could take it down hubbles. Once you perfected your kickflip from the first step, now you're able to take it down the 2-stair, you could take it down the 3-stair, or you could take it down the 4-stair. No matter how much the limit is, you could always take it down a set of stairs. Skateboarding has always evolved towards that direction where people have always ollied big giant stairs, kickflip big giant stairs, and it just keeps evolving. The more you kickflip stairs, the more stairs you kickflip, the further you're evolving that kickflip and showing other people that they could do it too as well. They could kickflip a 6-stair, they could kickflip a 7-stair. If you could do it, then probably they could do it as well. And that kind of shows the evolution of skateboarding as well. Skateboarding is evolving to different obstacles as well and making everything much more bigger. And if it's bigger, then it's harder to skate. And if it's harder to skate, it just makes skateboarding so much more harder to do, and it's making the limits of skateboarding and the tricks that are being done much more harder to get to. But it is still evolving to the point that street is always changing, so different obstacles are always showing up and different kinds of tricks could be done on a skateboard. So it's always evolving in that sense that there is no such thing as a limit to how much tricks you could do at a street spot, at a skate park, or anywhere you choose to be. That was my explanation for why there is no limits to skateboarding. Now time for the bad news. Why is there a limit on skateboarding? And my explanation to that. Now that there is no limit to the tricks that could be done on a skateboard, meaning you could do a 720 shove, you could do a 540 Smith grind, doesn't matter, you could do all that. But the problem is that humans have a limited time span of how far they could take skateboarding. Skateboarding isn't forever. There is a limit to how far the tricks could be done, meaning that we as human beings, we have a limited time in skateboarding and what tricks we could do. Whether you're a professional or a beginner or a local or as foreign as possible, there is a limit to how far as we as human beings have for skateboarding and the tricks that we could be doing. Let me take the first scenario that we had for the first form of evolution, the kickflip. In that example, I said that It took about a year for us to learn a kickflip to perfect it. Well, that's a year that you used to learn one trick. Now, what are you going to do with that trick? Are you going to learn more variations? Meaning you're going to want to learn heel flips, you're going to want to learn pop shove-its, you're going to want to learn front shove-its. Every trick that you're trying to learn, you're going to have to use some of your time in your skateboarding career to actually land it. Well, lucky for us, we as human beings, we have YouTube, meaning that we are able to learn faster and we're able to do tricks a lot more faster, so that way, now we don't have to waste as much time as we used to have to learn a new trick. We have YouTube, so now you can just go on YouTube and just look up the trick you want and you just see the advice that other skaters have. The amount of time that it used to take to learn a trick and that amount of time to learn a trick now is so much different, and it's going to help evolve skateboarding so much further because we're learning a lot more faster. If we're learning a lot more faster, then the process is going to take a lot less and we're able to do much more with our time in skateboarding. Even so, how far can you really do skateboarding tricks? There is a limit to how far we as human beings could do certain tricks. For example, it might take you a year or 3 years to land a 720 shove, but now to do it to a 50-50, now it's a lot more harder and much more difficult to do. And that's what I'm saying is, we have a limit to how much time and how much time we want to waste on a trick or a specific trick to do an MBD or never been done trick. So it's all based on the person. We have two people, like me and another person. The first person wants to land a 720 shove 50-50. Gets very viral for it. He's the first person to land it, MBD. Now you have another person, but he doesn't have the same trick. He doesn't want to use all his time just to learn a 720 shove. He wants to do the biggest kickflip. He wants to do the biggest, so he just works on kickflips. And now he just wants to work on kickflips and get it down whatever stair set he wants. The biggest stair set, and now he's the one known for the biggest stair set ever. And that's what I'm saying is, you get to choose what you want to learn and what you want to do. If all you do is work on a trick, a single trick, whether it's kickflip, tray flip, whatever, then you're able to evolve that trick a lot more easier. Meaning that you're able to kickflip 50 much more easier, you're able to tray flip 5-0 much more easier. Doesn't matter. As long as you have that trick perfect, now you're able to evolve it much more quicker. Let me talk to you guys about other evolutions and why it puts a limit on skateboarding and how far we can go. So, with the second scenario where we combine tricks, yes, you could combine tricks, but you gotta make sure that you have every single trick because there could be a lot of things that could go wrong with that trick. Do a kickflip from board, then you could always land primo, you could land upside down, you could snap your board doing it, or you could slip out on a board slide, you could mess up on the shove it when you're coming out. So there's a lot more technical and it's a lot more difficulty and there could be a lot more problems to go wrong with that one trick that you're trying to land, that you're trying to combine with other tricks. So make sure you have your board control up because that is the most important part of skateboarding. If you do get injuries, then once you get those injuries, then you gotta stay at home or you can't skate for a couple days, like if you have a rolled ankle. Injuries is what makes extreme sports very slow to evolve, and obviously you can't avoid them. Eventually they'll happen, but what you could do is what most people do is just do what they can and try their best to get back on a board. So with the impact that your body is going to be taking, there is a limit to how much your body could take impact. And obviously you reduce it with the exercise and the physical therapy that I was speaking before, but eventually you are going to feel it. Now, the last factor in skateboarding that prevents evolution all the time, wherever I go, there's always that one factor, and that is fear. Fear is a common emotion. The fear of landing the trick, a fear of injury, a fear of taking the impact, a fear of fear, meaning you're scared of everything that you have a fear of. And it will always prevent evolution because everybody's always scared. If there was no such thing as injuries or something that might happen to our bodies, then we'd be jumping down 20 stairs without a problem. But there's always a consequence to us skateboarding. So if we want to skate that sixth stair, the consequence is that we're having fear that we may not land, that we may get injured, we might be whatever. And that will always be a mental block for some skaters. Some skaters don't have that mental block, but some people do. And you have to make yourself very confident in that skateboarding trick. If you know how to kick from every single try, don't get yourself mental block. Just do it. The fear of doing a certain trick is going to prevent you from actually landing the trick, and it's going to prevent the evolution of skateboarding. And that is where The skating the big stuff is very difficult. Letting new tricks is very difficult because you're scared that you might roll your ankle or whatever. So you have to build that confidence. You have to tell yourself that you could do it every single try. The more time you waste on a mental block, the more time you're wasting not being able to land that trick. When that happens, when you do have that mental block, the most important part or the most important step to breaking through is taking action. So when you take action, you don't think. When you don't think, you just do. Fear will always slow down the process of evolution in skateboarding, but those who have the confidence to overcome their fear will evolve skateboarding even beyond what most people imagine. These are my thoughts on the limits of skateboarding and the evolution of skateboarding. And if you guys agree or disagree with anything that I said, please leave it in the comments below. If you guys like this video, please leave a thumbs up and subscribe if you want to see more videos.